Thank you very much for the introduction and for getting me to speak here. I'm just going to introduce something I did recently with a focus on constant mean curvature hypersurfaces. So let me quickly introduce the basic object of study for this. So we always think of a hypersurface inside an ambient manifold. So the ambient dimension at the node by n plus 1, and the hypersurface dimension is n. So I assume we have a uninormal vector fields along it. So the basic first variation formula says that if we move this hypersurface by some ambient deformations, say if you have a flow which had denoted by phi t, so that's from the ambient space to the ambient space, and t is small. So each of them is a diffeomorphism. This is one parameter family of diffeomorphism. So we can calculate the change of the area for this hypersurface. That is, we move the hypersurface by this flow. And at each time t, we can evaluate the area of this hypersurface. And then this is a function from t to this number. So we can take a derivative and let t to be 0. So the first variation formula says that this is the integral of the hypersurface of this function times nu dotted with x, which I'll explain. So in this formula, h is the mean curvature of this hypersurface, and x is the velocity of this variation. Okay. So we say a hypersurface is CMC. So if this mean curvature is identical to some constant c. So I want to say that if c is not zero, so this gave a calibration. So this is actually, orientation of the hypersurface. So this is always orientable if c is not zero. So the basic question that I'm interested in is as follows. So let's say we're given a closed Riemannian manifold. So can we find an example or find a solution for this geometric subject? In particular, I can ask even more. So for what number c, so that there exists so say a closed smooth CMC such that this mean curvature is exactly this number c. So this is a question that I was interested in. So before I state the results known along this direction, I just want to give a quick remark that this topic is actually interesting because CMC hypersurfaces appears in isoparametric problems, appears in the interface theory for copolymers, and also is very important for general relativity. So the known results before we think about this problem is that so if C is zero, so the CMC reduced to a minimal hypersurface, and the existence was the famous Ungreen piece theory. The solution is yes. There always exists a closed, smooth, embedded minimal hypersurface. So starting from the Ungreen piece theory, we can think about the perturbation theory, because if C is small, oh yeah, I just assume we are in lower dimensions, so don't think too much. So let's say so. There always exists a closed, smooth hypersurface. So the dimension restriction is that So we live from dimension 3 to 7. And in higher dimensions, we have a lot of singularities. So this guy has vanishing mean curvature. We also call the minimal hypersurface. So let's start with Amgren P theory and look for small c. So if we are in a generic metric, we can use perturbation theory to construct a CMC whose mean curvature is a small number. So by perturbation, by perturbing this Amgren P solution, so one can produce a closed smooth hypersurface whose mean curvature is a small number c. So that's just inverse function theorem. So one can also think from the other end, if the number c is very large. So the work was originated by my colleague Ye. So his idea is that we can try to desingularize a point to make CMC foliations near a given point. So we know that's always true in R3. So we have CMC foliations near every point. So he showed that in any Riemann manifold, if you had a point where the scalar curvature is non-degenerate, you can have CMC foliations. So by the results and some other people's later. So there exists CMC foliations. So near a point with certain assumptions. So the picture is that you think about local small foliations. So one can imagine that all the mean curvature for this example is super large. And the mean curvature diverges to infinity if you collapse to the center. OK, so these results partially solve this question, but there's still a gap between the small c and large c. And there are also many other constructions for closed CMC hypersurfaces, but mainly not in the prescribing mean curvature point of view. So I'll just stay up to here. So last year, with my collaborator on the back, so it's Jonathan. So we actually solved this question. Completely, so our results is just change that to be yes. So let's say this question is yes. The answer is true, while still assuming that the dimension is between 3 and 7. So that's to say, given any closed Riemann manifold with a Riemann metric, so for any number c, we can always produce a closed, smooth hypersurface whose mean curvature is given by this number c. OK, any question up to here? OK, I like to compare the results with another conjecture by Arnold and by Novikov. So I think this is interesting to see here. So what's the conjecture is that given topological S2, so this is a topological two-sphere with arbitrary Riemannian metric. So the conjecture, the existence of a closed embedded curve gamma, so whose geodesic curvature, so this is the geodesic curvature, is equal to be an arbitrary given number. It's very analogous to this question. So I want to say that our results is a higher dimensional analog for this problem. So though our results, our method cannot solve the one-dimensional case, but we can do higher dimensions. Pretty surprised. OK, so let me say a few words about the basic idea to approach our result. So we start with the variational point of view. So So particularly if the hypersurface sigma bounds a domain, so if sigma is a boundary of some domain, so we look at the following weighted functional. So this number C is the C in the question. So that's defined as, so the area of the boundary subtract the number C times the volume of this domain omega. So one can see that if I redo my first version formula for this functional, so the simple result is that sigma is CMC with mean curvature identical to C if and not only if sigma is a critical point for this new functional. So our approach follows this idea. So we try to develop a partial Mohr theory for this new functional, generalizing the corresponding theory by Almgren and Pease for the area functional. So that's a Meemac construction. I thank Lucas for a very nice motivation for the Meemac theory. So let me just quickly repeat his picture. So if this is a manifold M, so we consider a one-parameter family of open size. So particularly, we start with the empty set or point. So you can see this is empty set. Then we try to use this open size to sweep out the whole boundary. To sweep out the whole manifold. Say this is my omega 1/2. So my omega 1 is the whole manifold. So then one can define a min max value for this new functional. So that is for each of this one parameter family, we calculate and take the maximum when t goes from 0 to 1, and then take infimum among all possible one-parameter families. So we call this number LC. So Jonathan and I proved that this number is actually positive, and this number equals the AC for some omega naught, where the boundary of, omega infinity. The boundary of omega infinity is smooth. So actually, then you can deduce that the boundary is a non-trivial constant mean curvature hypersurface. This is a given number C. Maybe in the last minutes, let me quickly describe what we want to do for the next step. Can I use this board? OK, so I want to see that R-node also conjecture this conjecture by changing C to be a function. So R-node also conjecture that for any smooth function on S2, so there exists a curve, say smooth closed embedded, whose geodesic curvature at each point on the curve equals the value of this function. So we also want to generalize this prescribing curvature problem for hypersurfaces. Particularly, we have a preprint a month ago. So we proved that the still drawn work is Jonathan this year. So we show that there exists a generic, this open and dense generic set of smooth functions such that, so for any function inside this generic set, so we produce a closed, smooth hypersurface. So whose mean curvature at each point is this function. Okay. And our next goal is try to use approximation to do this for all smooth functions, to generalize from this set to the whole set.
Can you control the topological type of this?
No, I cannot do it at this moment. I think it's time to stop.
Oh, thank you very much.